Hello students, welcome to class. How are you doing? I'm happy to see you in class again. This is Ms. Adama Ogu, and today we'll be looking at our final topic in agricultural science for SS2. Amazing that we've come to the end of the 10th topic. Thank God for that. I hope that for other topics we treated, you copied the notes and done the assignment that was sent for each topic. It's very important to do that. And in case of anything you don't understand, you can always send me your question, send me a chat on the school website or via my WhatsApp number and answer as soon as I get them. And so far, so good. We talked about topic in we talked about weeds, we talked about crop improvements, we talked about demand and supply, then we talked about what other topic did we talk about? Then we talked about animal nutrition. So these are the topics we talked about, basic economic principle, which is demand and supply. Then we talked about farm record and farm accounts. Yes, these are the topics we treated in this term. It has been a very interesting term, I tell you. So in this class, we'll be looking at our final topic, which is on animal nutrition, the continuation of last week's topic. So let's look at what we are dealing with, agricultural sciences to the 9th topic and animal nutrition continuation. So let's look at our learning objective. At the end of the class, you should be able to define ration, diet, and balanced diet. They state the types of ration or diet and their uses, state the factors to be considered in determining animals' feed, define malnutrition, state common nutritional deficiency, nutritional diseases in farm animals, their causes, symptoms, and correction. These are the things we are going to look at in today's class. So now, what is ration? Okay, before I go into this topic, let's quickly do an overview of what we did last class. We talked about animal nutrition. That is important that a farmer understand the nutrients or the best way to feed his animal for maximum productivity. Because the farmer is either keeping the animals for meat, for their eggs and their different products. So it's very important, food is important for these animals to be able to produce what is needed by the farmer. So those are what we looked at. We looked at different types of feeds. We talked about BESA or carbohydrate concentrate, talk about protein concentrate and the rest of them. Just try as much as possible to go back to the video. You don't understand. So let's look at today's topic, ration. Now, when we say ration, ration is the total amount of food required or taken in by an animal. So that is the meaning of ration. The total amount of food consumed by an animal in a day is known as ration. Then when we say diet, a diet is a formulated feed regularly given to animal to meet specific metabolic or physiological function such as growth, lactation, maintenance of pregnancy, reproduction, and egg production. For example, in poultry, in a poultry farm, you might have boilers and you might have layers. Now, boilers are raised for their meat, while layers are raised for egg production. Now, the feed that you give to a boiler will be different from the feed you give to a layer because they are performing two different functions. So for the boiler, mostly they'll be giving food that contains high amounts of fat. While for the layer, they'll be giving food that mostly contains high calcium content and proteinous food and high calcium content with vitamins and minerals. So they will be giving such food that will help them lay eggs. But for the broilers, we're giving fat food. So those different foods I just mentioned, they are known as diets. While ration is the total amount of food that the boiler will eat in a day, while for the layer, the total amount of food will eat. So diet is this specially formulated food for the particular animal to suit the purpose for which it is raised. Then we have balanced ration or balanced ration or diet. Now, a ration or diet is said to be balanced when it contains all the essential nutrients in their adequate quantity and proportion to completely meet the food requirements of a particular animal. For example, talked about boiler and layer just now. If the food of a layer is given to a boiler, that feed is unbalanced, that diet is not balanced. So for a diet to be balanced, it must suit the purpose for which the animal is being raised. So now let's look at type and uses of ration diet. Number one, have production ration. Now, when we say production ration, remember that the importance of diet for the animal is for it to meet the specific purpose it is raised for. Now, production is the very vital aspect of it. For the animal to be able to produce, it must eat properly. So its feed depends on the food that the animal takes will determine the amount of product it will give out. So now when we say production ration, it is the ration given to farm animals to enable them to produce. So for them to be actually produced accurately, they must be given the adequate food that they need, because their product depends on it. Now, categories of farm animals that require production ratio include fattening animals for meat production, that means extra addition of meat or flesh. Then pregnant animals, there are specific feed that will be given to them for the growing fetus. For the fetus to grow very well, they need particular diet. Then layers, they are giving some particular food for egg production and formation of shell, especially calcium containing feed, so that they can produce such food. So you have that category. Then boilers for rapid growth, then lactating or dairy animals for their milk production. So you need to give them proteinous food especially. Then steaming up or flushing for animals before mating to produce more ova. Now before the animals meet, that is for them to be able to produce more offspring, they need to give them some particular diet for production of more ova. So these are categories of production ratio. So number one is production ratio, that's the types of ratio. Then next one is maintenance ratio. Now, in maintenance ratio, this is the amount of feed that is given to farm animals just to maintain their normal portioning of the body. To maintain normal portioning of the body, they are giving maintenance ration. Now, in this particular maintenance ration, these animals are not giving this feed because they are looking forward for them to produce anything. No, but they are giving to them to keep them alive without losing or gaining weight, and then without any production purposes. So without any purpose of their produce, they are giving particular feed. For example, hay and straw are given to animals, especially during the dry season, just to keep them alive till the dry season ends, because at that time there is deficiency of actually fresh forages, fresh grasses. So for the animals to stay alive and maintain a constant weight, they are giving maintenance ration. So next one is weaning ration. Now weaning is the removal of an animal from the mother, a young growing animal from the mother. So weaning ration is actually given to this animal, especially when they want to separate the animal from the mother. When the mother is to produce a new individual, they will separate the young one from the mother. So to actually substitute for the deficiency of what the young one is lacking from the mother, they will give them what's known as weaning ration. So these are the types of ration or diet that we have. Now, factors that will determine the type of ration or diet that we're giving to the animal, number one and most important is the purpose for which the animal is kept. So the purpose for the animal is for which the animal is kept will determine the type of ration that will be given to that animal. For example, for meat, for milk, for egg, for hide and seek, there are particular feed that will be given to the animal. Another factor that determines type of food is class of animal. For example, pigs cannot digest roughages. So they don't have four compartment stomach that will help them in digestion of roughages. So they cannot be fed high content roughage food, feed with high content of roughages. So pigs cannot be fed. The same thing with poultry. They can't digest roughages. So poultry feed mainly on grains. So they will be giving food materials that contain grains. So class of animal determined. Then age of the animal, e.g. chicks of 0 to 6 weeks require more nutritious feed, that's 20% crude protein, than growers, which are 6 to 18 weeks, which require about 40% crude protein. So the age of the animal will also determine the type of feed that is given to the animal. Then the animal's condition of health. For animals which are sick, for example, there are particular feed that are given to them to help fasten their recovery processes. So those are known as, that's another factor that is considered. Maybe normally the animal is given fattening food because it's a meat producing food. But when the animal gets sick, they will start giving them such fattening food, but start giving them feed that will help them recover quickly. So those are another factor that can be considered. Then physiological state of the animal. So physiological state of the animal, e.g. pregnant animals are given some particular food, and lactating animals, that is animals that are breastfeeding, they are given particular feed to help the growing fetus or help in the production of milk for their young one. So this also determines the type of feed given to an animal. Then nutrient value and palatability of the feed. Now, when we say nutrient value, it means there are some feed that have low value. So, and some animals will not consume them. Maybe probably because they've been used to a particular feed. So, for them to consume the feed, you need to look at the nutrient value as a farmer and whether the animal readily eats such feed. So these are factors that a farmer needs to consider when determining the feed to give to animal. Then lastly, we are going to be looking at nutrient deficiency disease in farm animals. So when we say nutrient deficiency, generally the term malnutrition is used to refer to nutrient deficiency in animal, and this is as a result of maybe lack of a particular nutrient in a feed, or maybe the animal is not well fed, so it will start showing some signs and symptoms. For example, let's look at the different one. We have nutritional disease. Number one, rickets occurs in young animals, and it's caused by deficiency in calcium, phosphorus, or vitamin D. Now, the symptoms are malformation of the bones, flexible and curved bone, then soft shell eggs will be produced. So these are symptoms of rickets in animals. Then condition for this is to addition of fish meal, bone or oyster shell, or oyster shell to meat. Feed contain high calcium and phosphorus. So you add them to their feed to help them, their bones to be formed well. Remember, they occur in young animals. The next one is osteomalacia, and it occurs in adult animals. Adult animals like pregnant and lactating cows. Now, osteomalacia, not sure I'm getting the pronunciation. Pardon my pronunciation. Is an equivalent, is an adult equivalent of cricket. Cricket occur in young animals. As they are growing, there will be malfunctioning of the bone, that the bones will not be formed well. But this other one is forming already grown animals. Now, it's as a result of deficiency in calcium and phosphorus and vitamin D as well. Then you have the symptoms are retarded growth, low fertility and reproduction, curving of bones, brittle bones, and fracture. Brittle bones means that they can they will be so strong that they are so hard. Now, to correct such deficiency, you need to raise the phosphorus intake through addition of wheat bran. Wheat bran is very high in the calcium and phosphorus, and then bone meal and oyster shell. These are then other ones. We have ketosis. It occurs in meat, in high meat production animals, especially cattle. Now, causes are low level of blood sugar and high concentration of ketones in the body. Ketones is actually one of the products from carbohydrate digestion. So when there is low level of sugar and high concentration of ketones bodies in the blood, it will cause ketosis. And so symptoms are sharp drop in lactation and loss of appetite. So to correct that, feed carbohydrate and molasses and give glucose injection to animals. So to correct that, that is what you do. Another one is milk fever, hypocalcemia. Hypocalcemia is part of my pronunciation. Now, it occurs mostly in dairy cows or female cattle shortly after calving. When we say female cattle, that's cows, when they've given birth, shortly after they've given birth, calving is known as the process of giving birth in cows, so, or in cattle. So that process is known as calving. So shortly after this might occur. Now, it's caused by deficiency of calcium. Now, it can cause little symptoms, include loss of consciousness, nervousness, and loss of appetite. Now, to help correct that, you need to feed the animal with oyster or bone meal and give calcium injection. Sometimes, to correct this meat fever, like not a corrective measure, but preventive measure. Just before the animal gives birth, they are giving injected with calcium injection to prevent this meat fever from occurring. Then, next one, you have grass tenancy. It occurs both in young and adult cattle, sheep, and sometimes pig. Now, the causes is low blood magnesium. Symptoms include nervousness, abnormal gait. When we say abnormal gait, it means that is the way the animal walks, it will be abnormal. Then hyper irritability. That means they react to everything, like they are very hypersensitive to things around them, and then convulsion. Now you be like conversion in animal, yes, it does happen. Then to correct that, you have to do supplementation of feed with high level feedstuff, e.g. molasses. Molasses are really very nutritious. So the addition of magnesium oxide or mineral and mineral mixtures in feed that helps to correct this disease. Then another one is covering, which is lack of vitamin C. So symptom is infected or injury around the connective tissue and bleeding from skin. So to correct this, feed vegetable and fruits to animal. Fruits and vegetables are very rich in vitamin C. So to correct scurvy, you need to feed them with lots of vegetable and feed. Then night blindness is caused by lack of vitamin A. That is poor ability to adapt to dim light. So feed with yellow maize to correct that. So to correct deficiency of night blindness, feed with yellow maize. Then beriberi is lack of vitamin B1, that's thiamine. So symptoms include fatigue, loss of appetite, and weight. Now feed the animals with meat, cereals, and vegetables to correct beriberi. So these are common diseases. There are a whole lot of others, but these are the commonest ones. If we say we should look at these, all the disease, malnutrition disease in animals, quite a number of them, and it will take a lot of time. So in your own study, try as much as possible to develop more for yourself. Research, do a research on malnutrition diseases in farming animals, and you see quite a number of them. So this is where we end the class. So the for your reference, go to the uploaded notes for week 9 on the school website. You can go to exam focus agricultural science and essential agricultural science by Wena. So this is where we end the tense work. Please try as much as possible to go through all your notes and do all the assignments. And please, if there's anything you don't understand during the course of studying any of the topics as well, try as much as possible to send in your question, and I will be glad to answer them. Thank you very much for your cooperation so far, so good. I hope to see you when school resumes. We hope that this ends before the next term resumes, so that I can see your beautiful and handsome face. Thank you very much for listening. So, till next time, I remain Ms. Adana, your agricultural science teacher. Keep staying safe, and God bless you. Bye.